Hi there, and welcome. My name is Michael Kentenich, and I'm a Microsoft Technical Trainer. In this video, I will talk about unleashing the power of scalability and efficiency with Azure Container Apps. Hey there, fellow developers. I probably don't need to tell you how amazing containerized applications are. And I probably also don't need to tell you that Kubernetes is a powerful platform that makes orchestrating microservices a piece of cake, if it's configured and managed correctly, which sometimes can be like that overly complicated puzzle box that you got as a gift. Intriguing, but a tad overwhelming. Imagine there would be something that would give you the power of Kubernetes, but without the hassle of managing a cluster of nodes, networking, and orchestration. A place where you can focus on your code, your app's logic, and keep your stress levels in check. You can stop imagining now. This place exists. It's a service called Azure Container Apps. In this video, I will describe the features and benefits of Azure Container Apps, and also show you how to deploy a container app in Azure by using the Azure CLI. Container Apps is a serverless platform that lets you run containerized applications with less infrastructure and lower expenses. You don't have to deal with service settings, container coordination, and deployment specifics because Container Apps provides all the necessary server resources to make your applications reliable and safe. There are a few common use cases of Azure Container Apps: deploying API endpoints, hosting background processing jobs, handling event-driven processing, and overall running microservices. Azure Container Apps is built on Azure Kubernetes Service. It is ideal for creating Kubernetes-style applications without needing direct access to all the native Kubernetes APIs and cluster management. Container Apps offer a fully managed experience based on best practices. Apps built on Azure Container Apps can dynamically scale based on HTTP traffic, event-driven processing, including any KEDA-supported scaler, that is the Kubernetes event-driven autoscaling, or CPU and memory load. A container app environment is a secure area that groups together container apps. It runs the container app's runtime, which takes care of operating system upgrades, scale operations, failover procedures, and resource balancing for each environment. Container apps are deployed inside this environment. In a system that uses microservices, function calls are distributed over the network. You need to handle failures, retries, and timeouts to deal with the dispersed nature of microservices. Container apps gives you the basic tools for running microservices, but Dapper offers a more advanced microservice programming model. That is the distributed application runtime integration. Dapper has features such as observability, pub/sub approach, and mutual TLS secured service-to-service invocation with retries and more. In this unit, I went over the features and the benefits of Azure Container Apps and showed you how to deploy a container app in Azure by using the Azure CLI. In the next unit, we will touch on some very important Azure Container Apps concepts: revisions, secrets, and Dapper integration. We'll look at how to create revisions and implement app secrets, and how Dapper integration works, what it can do for you with Azure Container Apps. Azure Container Apps runs on top of a managed Azure Kubernetes cluster. The details of Kubernetes configuration and container orchestration are managed for you. Containers in Azure Container Apps can use any runtime, programming language, or development stack of your choice. Like a regular AKS cluster, the containers are grouped in pods based on a configuration manifest that determines how many replicas are created, and the number of replicas you can have for an Azure Container App depends on the pricing tier. A more complex scenario is to run multiple containers in one container app. For example, you might want to have an agent that accesses logs from the main app container on a shared volume and sends them to a logging service, or a background service that updates a cache used by the main app container on a shared volume. This would be an example of using the sidecar pattern. To use images from private registries, you need to provide the credentials in the container app settings. Azure Container Apps uses revisions to handle different versions of container apps. A revision is a fixed snapshot of a container app version. You can use revisions to deploy a new version of your application or easily roll back to previous version. Revision scope changes create new revisions when you update your application. You can also update your container app from a specific revision. For this, you can use the AZ Container App Update command to change environment variables, compute resources, scale parameters, and deploy a different image. All of these changes will create a new revision. Azure Container Apps enables your application to keep confidential configuration values in a secure way. When secrets are set at the application level, container apps can access these protected values. Secrets have an application scope, and they're not tied to any specific revision of that application. Secrets don't also create new revisions when they are added, removed, or modified. Each revision of an application can use one or more of those secrets. The same secrets can be used by multiple revisions. And when you create a container app, secrets are defined using the secrets parameter. The Distributed Application Runtime, or DAPR, is an open source cloud-native computing foundation project. It is a set of incrementally adoptable features that simplify the authoring of distributed microservice-based applications. DAPR provides capabilities for enabling application intercommunication through messaging via PubSub or reliable and secure service to service calls. You don't have to use it, but you should definitely look into what it can do for you. DAPR offers unified APIs for communication, state, and workflow. DAPR uses the best practices in the industry for security, resiliency, and observability, so you can concentrate on your code. Service-to-service invocation, as seen on the slide, you can use this to discover services and perform reliable, direct service-to-service calls with automatic MTLS authentication and encryption. Or state management, which manages the state of transactions in all create, read, update, and delete operations. Publish and subscribe lets container apps that send and receive messages communicate through a middleman message broker. Bindings will trigger your applications based on events. And actors, where DAPR actors are units of work that use messages, run on one thread and can scale rapidly. For example, when the workload has sudden spikes. It also helps to integrate observability, send tracing information to an application insights backend, for example, and manage secrets, retrieve confidential information from your app code, or use protected values in your DAPR components. The following example, based on the Publish and Subscribe API, is used to illustrate core concepts related to DAPR in Azure Container Apps. When we look at the one indicator in the slide, DAPR is activated at the container app level by setting some DAPR arguments. These values are used for all revisions of a container app when it runs in multiple revisions mode. Second, each container app can access the DAPR APIs through a DAPR sidecar that is fully managed. The DAPR APIs can be called from your container app using HTTP or gRPC. The DAPR sidecar operates on HTTP port 3500 and gRPC port 50001. Third, the dapper has a modular design that uses components to provide functionality. Dapper components can be used by multiple container apps. The scopes array includes dapper app identifiers that determine which dapper-enabled container apps use a specific component at runtime. Check out the tutorials on Microsoft Learn and the dapper project site to learn more about implementing this in your container apps. Congratulations on exploring Azure Container Apps and its capabilities for deploying and managing microservices on a serverless platform. Azure Container Apps bridges the gap between serverless simplicity and containerization power. It's an excellent choice for scenarios where you want to focus on code, minimize infrastructure management, and still scale efficiently. With Azure Container Apps, unleash the full potential of your microservices architecture and drive innovation in your projects. Thanks for watching. Keep on learning.